Hi Sunil ji, good morning, welcome to the show. How are you, sir?
Good morning, thank you for having me on the show.
Sir, what is the outlook for commodities, especially bullion?
Okay, I think the gold and silver have shown some rebound. Actually, gold is trading above the crucial support of $1,800 at COMEX. In the domestic market, today the markets have opened 130 rupees positive from yesterday's level. So currently the rates are near to 47,700 mark. I believe it will maintain its positive momentum because there are a couple of fundamental factors that we are considering in the very short term. First and foremost is, Indian gold imports have again started showing some increment. Like April, May, June quarter, the average import has been around $7.9 billion worth of, gold. So Indian imports have started showing some improvement. On the same, front, if we see, even the central banks have started procuring gold to an extent. Again, they are kind of in line with the pre-COVID levels. Some of the central banks are planning to strengthen their balance sheet by increasing gold holdings. So a couple of things that may cap the prices, like dollar index is trading near to 93, which is close to 4 months high. That is something which is keeping the, gold prices around this level. But in the medium term, as the central banks are very clear about maintaining accommodative monetary policy, and the Delta variant of COVID again is a serious concern across US, UK and Europe over a period of time, I think that should keep the safe haven appeal for gold and silver up. So in the short term, we are expecting gold at COMEX level to touch around $1,840 mark. So another 20-30 improvement is what we are expecting at COMEX. If we convert that to Indian rupee, I think 49,000 rupees per 10 gram is what we are expecting for gold. Silver, on the other hand, is again trading above $25, crucial support at COMEX. In the domestic market, it is trading close to 67,200 now. So I believe it will maintain a range of 70,000 and 67,000. So any levels close to 67,000 will attract buyers. And 70,000 is what we are expecting the price in the near term. So we advise a buy in gold around 47,600 with a stop loss of 47,300. And near term target is 48,500. And overall, we think it may again touch 49,000 level. And silver can buy around 67,000. Stop loss can be 66,000. And a target of 69,000 and 70,000 is what we can expect.
Right, sir. Sir, what do you think about metal space, sir?
I think base metal prices have started showing a rebound. There are a couple of news, in the market. One is, anyhow, the industrial demand for base metals has been up. The forecast for base metal is, even today as we speak, it is positive. And even I think Fed's accommodative monetary policy stance is something which will, ensure that the money will be available cheaply across the markets. It will obviously support the manufacturing sector. And overall, if we see the stocks across the global warehouses, barring LME, the warehouse stocks are less by 10% when we compare it to last 2 months' stocks. So even that is something which is a concern, which is driving the base metal prices up. I think Chinese Central Bank also has reduced the cash holding limit for most of the banks. That is going to support manufacturing sector. And I think overall, global refined, base metal market is showing a deficit. For instance, copper market is showing a deficit of 19,000 metric tons globally. So that should support, copper prices. And I think overall demand is anticipated to outpace the supply in the medium term. That is supporting the prices. So overall, we are bullish on base metal prices. For instance, copper is currently trading at 757 in the domestic market, the August contract. We are expecting the prices to touch around 780. So we expect to buy around 755 level, maintain a stop loss of 745, and one can target 780. And then most probably we may also see 800 levels again. On the other, apart from copper, I believe nickel is also one of, the peak of the commodity on the base metal category. We are expecting the prices to trade above 1500 in the domestic market. Currently they are trading at 1490. One can buy around 1490, 1480 level. 1460 can be a stop loss, and 1550 to 1570 can be a target in the near term.
Right, sir. Sir, what do you think about natural gas and oil?
I think natural gas prices have reached overbought zone, I can say that. Because overall, if we see, in the domestic market, 300 is the price at the moment. Internationally, the prices have moved up because of hotter weather conditions. So basically, the usage of air conditioning has gone up, and that is something which is supporting the prices. Plus, since the prices are up, US export numbers have been better. That is the reason why even the international natural gas prices have gone up. But I believe the prices have discounted all the fundamentals, and we may see some correction, some profit booking in natural gas prices. I recommend a sell around 300 levels, which is current level. One can maintain a stop loss of 310, and in the near term, I believe it may again come back to 260, 270 level.
Sir, what do you think about agri commodities, sir?
I think most of the agri commodities have again started showing bounce back. I mean, the pick of the commodity can be soybeans. Soybean prices in the domestic market are on upward freeze today. The prices that I saw just a few minutes back was around 9,100. Now, overall, global demand for soybean and other oilseed products is on the rise. Specifically on the soybean front, being a pick of the commodity for agri traders. The plantation of oilseed like soybean is comparatively lesser than what it was last year. To be precise, 11.2 million hectares is what is the planting number versus the last year's 12.6 million hectares. So that is something which will possibly impact the output as we move ahead. And overall, if we see the progress of monsoon is also one of the reason why the prices are moving up, because the certified seeds scarcity in the market was also one of the reason why the sowing got in fact impacted over a period of time. But otherwise, if we see globally, China is something which is the demand driver. Overall global dry weather conditions is also impacting the overall output anticipated as we move ahead. If we see specifically, China is importing decently, especially China's imports from US also have gone up. So international soybean prices, or for that matter all the oilseed prices, are on the move. So I believe the domestic soybean prices may also go up. Even domestic factors are also supporting the prices, because most of the vessels are almost empty now, and is going to support the soybean prices. Even the demand is decently placed in the domestic market. The stockists and traders are running out of their holdings, so that should support the prices. I believe the prices may touch 9,500 in the short term, and we may think of buying it around 9,000 or 9,100 level. Maintain a strict stop loss of 8,800, because the prices are trading at near all-time high prices. So I believe one can maintain a stop loss of 8,800 and target 9,500 for soybean. Second pick of the commodity can be chana. Some short covering can be seen in chana. Currently, the prices are trading at 5,000 level, 5,030 level. We may see some pullback in prices. Again, the prices may touch 5,200 levels. The stock limit imposition is something which had hampered the prices, but over a period of time, government is considering some leverage on that decision. So obviously, that may support the prices in the short term. Plus, the prices had corrected from a decently high level. Now we can expect the prices to possibly touch around 5,150 level for chana. So I believe 5,000 can be a decent entry level for chana. Maintain a stop loss of 4,960 and a target of 5,150 to 5,200 can be expected.
Right, sir. Sir, are you happy with the monsoons?
Now the monsoon numbers are better comparatively. If we talk about 15 days back, it was a concern, but now I think the pace is picking up. I believe we will be in line with the anticipated monsoon expectations.
Okay, sir. So as such, there is no fear in the market now as far as monsoon is concerned.
Correct.
Okay. Right, sir. Sir, thank you so much for your time. It's always a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you very much.